IUPAC nomenclature is completed. Next, right? Structure of amine. Structure of amine. Okay, and tell me. So before going structure of amines, let us see first structure of ammonia. Structure of ammonia. Right. To understand the structure of ammonia, we need to know what is hybridization, right? Hybridization lone pair. Can you tell me what is the formula to calculate the hybridization? There is a formula: number of hybrid orbital is equals to sigma bond plus lone pairs. We will study in chemical bonding topic, need not to worry, but remember time being. So number of hybrid orbital equal to sigma bond plus lone pair. So therefore here in ammonia, nitrogen has one lone pair, there are three sigma bonds. Yes or no? Three sigma bond, one lone pair. So therefore, there are how many number of hybrid orbital? So three sigma bond, three plus lone pair is one. Three plus one, four. So therefore, there are four hybrid orbitals present in nitrogen, that is in ammonia. Therefore, if there are four hybrid orbitals are present, the hybridization is sp3. So therefore, it is possible in only in sp3. So the hybridization of nitrogen in ammonia is sp3, right? So sp3 hybridization, lone pair equal to 1. So sp3 one lone pair, what is the geometry? So the geometry of the molecule is pyramidal. So therefore in ammonia, sp3 hybridization, one lone pair and geometry is pyramidal. Then what is the bond angle? Bond angle is 107 degrees. So it is in ammonia. But we want methyl amine. Take down structure of methyl amine. Right, in methyl amine also similar to ammonia. Okay, similar to ammonia, there is a nitrogen, one lone pair. There are two hydrogen but one methyl group in place of hydrogen. Okay, so can you tell me number of hybrid orbital same or not? Number of hybrid orbital, three sigma bond plus one lone pair, which is equals to four. Therefore what is the hybridization? sp3. So hybridization is sp3 and lone pair is one lone pair. Then what is the geometry of the molecule? It is also pyramidal. Geometry is pyramidal. Okay. Next, then what is the bond angle? Now tell me, in case of ammonia, the bond angle in between any two hydrogen is how much? It is 107 degrees. No. It is 107 degrees and of course geometry is pyramidal. It is pyramidal. But in case of methyl amine, there is a one methyl group in place of hydrogen and lone pair will be same. Now it also has same geometry. Pyramidal, but what is the bond angle? So bond angle, whether greater than 107 or less than 107. See here, there is a methyl group and hydrogen, right? In between methyl group hydrogen, the repulsion will be more compared to this hydrogen and hydrogen, because these two hydrogens are small in size. But here in place of hydrogen, there is a methyl group. So methyl group is a bulky group. Due to bulky group, this methyl group hydrogen repels more. So due to repulsions, this methyl group move away. It means bond angle is greater than 107. Therefore, in case of methyl amine, the bond angle is 108. 108 degrees. Suppose if there are two methyl group here, one more methyl group, one more, two methyl group, again it is more than 108. If there are three methyl groups, more than 108, it means it's again more than this. Therefore, in place of methyl group, if there is a ethyl group, bond angle still it is increases. Okay, so in this way you can identify the bond angles. Okay, taken. Right, next. Right, see, next important is amines having three different groups on nitrogen can be optically active. For example, let us take amines containing three different groups. Here, let us take hydrogen and methyl. Come on, tell me, this nitrogen having how many groups? One is a ethyl, hydrogen and methyl. Therefore, amines having three different groups on nitrogen are optically active. So, we study in organic compound. If any organic compound having four different groups on carbon, they are called chiral, it is called chiral carbon and it is optically active. Right? Like similar to organic compound, in amines also, amines having three different groups on nitrogen are optically active. And they are optically active and there will be a there will be interconversion. Let us take, this is one amine, right? Ethyl, methyl, hydrogen. This amine, it is optically active. It converts into another form. It is nitrogen lone pair, hydrogen, methyl, and it is ethyl. Okay? So these two are called enantiomers because it is one, if it is a D enantiomer, it should be L enantiomer. So therefore, D and L both are here interconvertible. So therefore, can I say these two are what? They are, of course, enantiomers. But we also know that what are enantiomers? Non-superimposable mirror images. Okay. So for example, if you write, this is a one form, hydrogen, methyl, it is a ethyl, you can write C2H5 ethyl. Okay, and tell me, it is like mirror and its mirror image is hydrogen, it is methyl and C2H5. Come on, tell me, so these two are what? They are non-superimposable. So non-superimposable, but they are what? Mirror images. So therefore they are called what? Nothing but they are enantiomers, right? So non-superimposable mirror images are called enantiomers. So therefore amines having three different groups like hydrogen, methyl, ethyl or anything A, B, C can be optically active, and they are optically active, they are interconvertible. So one can convert into another. This is called flipping. So both are, they are rapidly interconvertible. So due to rapid interconversion, so these two cannot be isolated, these two cannot be separated, which is called resolution. The word is resolution. What is resolution? Resolution is the process of separation of one enantiomer from the mixture. So they take, for example, these two are the enantiomers. In these two enantiomers, is it possible to separate one enantiomer? Not possible, because one can interconvert into another, that is also rapidly. So therefore both are rapidly interconvertible, so therefore these two enantiomers cannot be separated from each other, which is called resolution. Resolution of isomers, enantiomers, is not possible due to rapid interconversion. Okay, read on. Read on. Amines having three different groups on nitrogen. Amines having three different groups on nitrogen are optically active. Amines having three different groups on nitrogen or optically active or optically active comma or optically active. Okay, take example, then take example ethyl methyl amine. Example ethyl methyl amine. Next point, right? These two enantiomers cannot be resolved. These two enantiomers cannot be resolved because they are rapidly interconvertible. Because they are rapidly interconvertible, and it is called flipping. Next point. Due to rapid interconversion, it is difficult to separate these two enantiomers. It is difficult to separate these two enantiomers. So take those two. Next is isomerism. Finished? Next is isomerism. Come on, tell me. Isomerism in amines. So amines can exhibit how many types of isomerism? One, chain isomerism, possible, no? So chain isomerism possible. Two, positional isomerism because position of amine group. Three, functional isomerism. And four, metamerism. Therefore, amine can exhibit four type of isomerism. One, chain isomerism. Two, positional isomerism. Three, functional and metamerism. Right. So amines can exhibit one, chain isomerism. Two, positional isomerism. And three, functional isomerism. Four, metamerism. Okay, tell me. So what is chain isomerism? What are chain isomers? See, all isomers having same molecular formula, no? They must have what? Same molecular formula. Molecular formula will be same in all the cases. Then now in chain isomerism, the organic compound which are having same molecular formula, but they differ in parent chain. They differ in the length of the parent chain. one having four carbon atom, one having two carbon, three carbon atom, or one having five carbon atom in a parent chain, other having three like four. So therefore, the organic compound which are having same molecular formula, but they differ in length of parent chain, called chainosomers. Second one is positional isomer. The organic compound which are having same molecular formula, but they differ in position of the functional group. Here amine is a functional group, like one amine, three amine, two amine. So they differ in position of the functional group. Next is functional isomerism. The organic compound which are having same molecular formula, but they differ in what? Functional groups. So this is, we have studied functional group like primary, secondary, tertiary amine, right? So primary amine, secondary amine, tertiary amine, these three are the functional isomers. So they differ in the functional group. Finally, metamerism. The organic compound which are having same molecular formula, but they differ in what? Attachment of alkyl group to the functional group. They differ in attachment of alkyl group to the what? Functional group, that is amine functional group. Then they are called metamers. Okay, so let's see. First one is chain isomerism. Read all of you. Chain isomerism. Right on. The organic compound which are having same molecular formula, but they differ in length of what? Parent chain. So the organic compound which are having same molecular formula, but they differ in the length of the parent chain. Okay, so for example, CH3 CH2 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 NH2, tell me, what is the IUPAC name of this? 1 2 3 4, butane, 1 amine. So butane, 1 amine. Can you tell me its chain isomer is? Write that long chain. CH3 CH CH3 CH2 NH2. Tell me now, parent chain has how many carbon atom? So here parent chain has 4 carbon atom. Here parent chain has 3 carbon atoms, but both are having same molecular formula. The molecular formula of this and molecular formula of this, both are same. But parent chain has 4 carbon atom, parent chain has 3 carbon atom. So therefore, both are chain isomers. It is a 2-methyl propane, which 1 amine. So 2-methyl propane, 1 amine. So these two are the example for chain isomers. Therefore, amines can exhibit chain isomerism. Next, positional isomerism. Positional isomerism. Tell me. So what are positional isomerisms? The organic compound which are having same molecular formula, but they differ in what? Position of the functional group. Here amine, the position of amine group. Okay, like 2-amine, 1-amine, 3-amine. So like that, they must be differ in the position of functional group or amine group, called positional isomers, and phenomenon is called positional isomerism. Right on. Right. The organic compounds which are having same molecular formula, but they differ in what? So position of amine group or here functional group. Position of functional group or amine group, called positional isomers, and this phenomenon is called positional isomerism. Okay. For example, let us take butane 1 amine. Okay, so it is a butane 1 amine. Tell me its positional isomer. Butane 2 amine. It is 1, 2, 3, 4. So it is a butane 1 amine, and its positional isomer can be written it is 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is what? Butane 2 amine. So therefore, butane 1 amine, butane 2 amine, both are having same molecular formula, but differ in what? The position of the amine group. Here position of amine group is 1, here is 2. Therefore, these two are positional isomers. Okay, next. Third one, functional isomerism. Functional isomerism. Tell me. So, what are functional isomers? The organic compound which are having same molecular formula, but they differ in functional groups. Like primary amine, secondary amine, tertiary amine. These two are the functional, these three are what? Functional isomers. Okay, read. The organic compounds which are having same molecular formula. The organic compounds which are having same molecular formula, but they differ in what? But they differ in functional groups. But they differ in functional groups called functional isomers. And this phenomenon is called functional isomerism. Okay, let us take example. It is a primary amine. Okay, can you write the same molecular formula? With same molecular formula, secondary amine?
Yes.
CH3, CH2, NH, CH3. This is a secondary amine with same molecular formula. So therefore, primary amine, secondary amine, both are having same molecular formula. They are functional isomers. So can a tertiary amine with same molecular formula? CH3, CH2, no, CH3. N, CH3, it is CH3. It is a tertiary amine, no? It is also having same molecular formula. So, three are having same molecular formula, but their functional groups are different. Here, functional group is NH2. In last class, we have studied primary amine. Here, functional group is NH, secondary amine. Here is N, tertiary amine. Therefore, they differ in functional group. Therefore, they are called what? Functional isomers. Next, fourth one is metamerism. Metamerism. Okay. Right. In metamerism, let us take example. CH3, CH2, it is NH, CH2, CH3. What is this? Diethyl amine. No, common name. Diethyl amine. So diethyl amine, can we write CH3, it is NH, CH2, CH2, CH3. What is this? Methyl propyl amine. Now question is, whether both are having same molecular formula or not? Both are having same molecular formula. You see, number of carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4. So number of carbon 4, hydrogens 5 plus 5, 10 plus 1, 11, nitrogen is 1. Here, number of carbon 1 plus 3, 4, number of hydrogen, so here is 5, 7, 7 plus 3, 10, 11, and nitrogen is 1. So both are having same molecular formula, right? The organic compounds which are having same molecular formula, but they differ in attachment of alkyl group to what? functional group. Here there are two ethyl groups are attached. Here is one methyl group, one is propyl group is attached. Therefore, the organic compounds which are having same molecular formula but they differ in attachment of alkyl groups to the functional group. Here is amine. Okay, to amine group, the nitrogen atom. They are called metamers, and this phenomenon is called metamerism. Right? The organic compounds which are having same molecular formula, but they differ in attachment of alkyl groups to the functional group. Called metamers. And this phenomenon is called metamerism. Take example. Methods of preparation of amines. Okay. Next, right? Methods of preparation of amines. Okay, let's see one by one. Let us write first all. One, take down. Reduction of nitro compounds. Reduction of nitro compounds to Hoffman ammonolysis. Three, reduction of nitriles. Nitriles, nothing but cyanides. It is also called Mendius reduction. Four, reduction of amide, comma, oxime and azide. Azides, five. Hoffman bromide degradation. It's one important reaction. Sixth one, very, very important. Gabriel thalamide synthesis. It is also one of the important reaction. Seventh one, from alcohol. Eight, from carboxylic acids. Nine, from alkyl halides. Ten, from aldehydes and ketone. 11, from RMGX. What is RMGX? Grignard reagent. From Grignard reagent. Decarboxylation of alpha amino carboxylic acids. Okay, so these are the some important methods of preparation of amines. Okay, but see, if you see NCERT textbook, you can find only first six. In NCERT textbook, it is there. Reduction of nitro compound is there. Second one, Hofmann ammonolysis, it is also there. Third one, reduction of nitrile, nothing but alkane nitrile, cyanides. Nitriles are called cyanides, or cyanides are called nitriles. It is also there, which is called Mendius reduction. It is one important named reaction. And reduction of amide is there. Oxime azide not there, but amides are there. And it is there, Hofmann bromide degradation and Gabriel thalamide, it is also there. Okay, so in textbook till here is there. Remaining reactions not there in this topic, but these reaction comes in different topic. That's whatever the reaction related to this topic, we'll study here. When we get in other topic, it become easy. That is the reason we'll study all together. Okay, so ashte bitre textbook note idella sir extra maartta idare idella bekagilla ankobedri extra madak nanage time illa first okay, so therefore nothing is extra, everything it is there in textbook ide, overall textbook alli irutte. You need not to see in that page only, that topic only. Okay, and moreover, I told you, in organic chemistry you must follow textbook, strictly must follow textbook, particularly reactions. In organic chemistry, the questions given, two type of questions given, one in text question and exercise questions. In text question given with exam, with given with answers, that you need to practice it, as well as exercise questions given. For exercise questions, answer is not given there, but last page answer is given. You can check answer, you can do it. So therefore, equations you must practice in organic chemistry. Majority time we can expect the question which is given textbook. As this question kelbodu, kelidare keltare. Okay, now let's see reduction of nitro compounds. First one, come on, tell me. Reduction, what is a reduction? Addition of hydrogen, removal of oxygen. Okay, so addition of hydrogen or removal of oxygen is nothing but reduction, right? So therefore, can you tell me what are the nitro compounds? What is nitro compound? RNO2, like nitro alkane. Yes or no? So nitro alkane. Nitro alkanes undergo reduction, they form corresponding amines. But important is, what are the reducing agents? So here, which reducing agents can be used? Here there are three important reducing agent one can be used. One is, we all know that very commonly used, hydrogen in presence of nickel catalyst or platinum catalyst or even palladium catalyst. Therefore, hydrogen in presence of rainy nickel, or it is a powdered form, finely divided nickel, which is called rainy nickel, or platinum or palladium can be used. If not this, but very commonly used is tin concentrate HCl or iron concentrate HCl. So tin and iron metals reacts with hydrochloric acid, they produces hydrogen gas. Therefore, they can also be act as a reducing agent. If not this, you can also use lithium aluminium hydride. So we all know that lithium aluminium hydride, sodium borohydride, very strongly and commonly using reducing agents. So therefore, here lithium aluminium hydride can also be used. Now therefore tell me, what is the statement? Nitro alkanes or nitro compounds undergo reduction in presence of any one of this reducing agent to form corresponding amine. Okay, for example, now let us take nitro compound RNO2. Okay, now to convert a nitro group to NH2 group, how many hydrogen required? 2 or 6? Because now 2 hydrogen we are adding here and we need to remove 4 oxygen. No? To remove 4 oxygen, to remove 2 oxygen, 4 hydrogen required. So therefore total how many? We require 6 hydrogen. Therefore nitro compound plus 6 hydrogen in presence of, you can take any reducing agent, tin and concentrated HCl. Come on, tell me. This NO2 group converts into primary amine plus 2 oxygen, 4 hydrogen will get 2H2O. This is a reaction. Therefore, nitro compound converts into what? Primary amine. So, this is a reduction. Okay, right on. Nitro compounds undergo reduction in presence of, write this, in presence of hydrogen, nickel, platinum, palladium catalyst, or tin concentrate HCl, iron concentrate HCl, or lithium aluminium hydride to form corresponding primary amines. Okay. Take the reaction. Example. Nitromethane plus 6 hydrogen lithium aluminium hydride. Write the product. Nitroethane plus 6 hydrogen, you can take tin concentrated HCl. Even you can take nitrobenzene. Nitrobenzene plus 6 hydrogen tin concentrated HCl. Write the products. Tell me. Here NO2 nitro group get converts into primary amine. What is this? Methanamine. Okay. Next. So here also NO2 converts into primary amine. It is ethanamine. Next. Here also NO2 converts into amine which is called aniline or benzenamine. So what is a byproduct? In all the cases, 2 water molecule is the byproduct. Okay. All right, one note. This is in electrochemistry. One question is given, in text question, not in exercise questions. In exercise question, this question is given. Nitrobenzene C6H5NO2, okay, converts into C6H5NH2. Okay, so what is the equivalent mass of nitrobenzene. And actually we need to calculate the how much amount of nitrobenzene get converts into aniline. That is in electrochemistry. By using Faraday first law, second law, you can calculate. Okay, leave that. We need to calculate this first. What is the equivalent mass of nitrobenzene? Come on, tell me. So how to calculate equivalent mass? To calculate equivalent mass, we need to know n factor first. Tell me anybody, what is n factor in this equation? So to calculate n factor, we need to write equation in detail. C6H5NO2 nitrobenzene. Okay, this nitrobenzene has to convert into, here NO2 group has to convert into amine. Okay, so we require how many H plus ion? We require total 6 H plus ion as well as 6 electron required, because 6 positive becomes 6, 6 positive and 6 negative neutral, which gives us to C6H5NH2 plus 2H2O. It is a balanced equation. So therefore, now tell me here, 1 mole of nitrobenzene can gain how many electron? 6 electron. Therefore, n factor is 6. Since n factor is 6, what is the equivalent mass of nitrobenzene? So yes, equivalent mass is equals to molar mass divided by 6. Okay, so this question given in electrochemistry. Next is Hofmann ammonolysis. Come on, tell me, what is Hofmann ammonolysis? Here, alkyl halide RX reacts with ammonia at 100 degrees Celsius, or else you can take a 373 Kelvin temperature. So therefore, alkyl halides reacts with ammonia at 100 degrees Celsius to form a mixture of primary, secondary, tertiary and quaternary ammonium salt. So this reaction is called Hofmann ammonolysis. So therefore, here it is X. Now here in this reaction, one X and one hydrogen, what can be removed? So minus HX can be removed, then the product is RnH2, which is called primary amine. This primary amine reacts with another mole of RX, alkyl halide. So you can remove another HX. So then what is the product is RnHr. What is this? Secondary amine. Secondary amine still has one more hydrogen. It also reacts with another mole of RX. What it form? RnRr, which is called tertiary amine. So this tertiary amine has lone pair. It is also reacts with another molecule of alkyl halide. Come on, tell me. Here minus HX. Again, one more HX can be removed, not HX. Now, it reacts with another mole of RX. What it forms? So, it forms quaternary ammonium, here X minus salt. It is a quaternary ammonium salt. Quaternary ammonium salt. So, this whole reaction is called a Hofmann ammonolysis. Okay, now. Not only first question, in Hofmann ammonolysis, whether is it possible to prepare any one amine? No. You can you prepare only primary amine? No. Can you stop the reaction only primary amine? No. So therefore, this method is not suitable to prepare any one particular amine. If you try to prepare primary amine, you will get along with primary, secondary, tertiary, even you will get quaternary. Therefore, this method is not suitable to prepare any particular amine. Therefore, because here you will get mixture of all amines. Since you will get all the mixture of amines, it is very difficult to separate all the amines. Yes or no? Because primary, secondary, tertiary, all these amines having similar properties. So due to similar properties, so you cannot easily separate them into a individual compound. Therefore, it is difficult to separate this primary, secondary, tertiary quaternary ammonium salt. Therefore, this method is not suitable to prepare any one particular amine. Okay, next question. Then, now this reaction, this particular reaction is a SN2 mechanism. It follows SN2 mechanism. So, in SN2 mechanism, this ammonia is a nucleophile. We will study SN2 later, but remember basic things. So, this ammonia is a nucleophile. Okay, so ammonia is a nucleophile. It is alkyl halide. So, therefore, do you remember in SN2 reaction, nucleophile attacks the alkyl halide from where? Backside of the leaving group and backside of this X group. Yes or no? So, here also ammonia attacks the alkyl halide from the opposite side of this X. Okay. So, therefore, it follows SN2 mechanism. Okay. This particular reaction is a SN2 mechanism. Okay. Next is, now can you prepare chloro that is aniline by this reaction? Is it possible to prepare aniline? So, in order to prepare aniline, what we should take? We should take a chlorobenzene, no? Tell me. So, take the chlorobenzene plus ammonia. Okay. Now, here temperature should be doubled, 200 degrees Celsius and 60 atm pressure in presence of cuprous oxide. Then this is possible. Will get aniline. Now question is, why this condition is doubled? And that what is the reason here? See, here reason is we compare with alkyl halide. This is a aryl halide. Aryl halides are less reactive than alkyl halide towards nucleophilic substitution reaction. Remember, chlorobenzene is less reactive than methyl chloride or alkyl halide in nucleophilic substitution reaction, because in chlorobenzene there is a 3 lone pair, right? So this one lone pair involved in where? Resonance. So due to resonance, what happened? There is a partial double bond between chlorine and this carbon gets. So due to this partial double bond, the breaking of the bond is difficult. We'll study in halorine topic. Okay. So therefore, haloarenes are less reactive compared to haloalkanes. The reason is, in haloarenes, they have PDCH, partial double bond character. Due to partial double bond character, the breaking of bond is difficult. Therefore, they cannot easily undergo nucleophilic substitution reaction. So that's what, even though we need to prepare aniline, we need to double the temperature and pressure here, catalyst required. This is the reason. So, aniline cannot be easily prepared by this method. Next is, what is the order of reactivity of different alkyl halide? Order of reactivity. So, what is the order of reactivity? Let us take alkyl halide is RF, RCl, RBr, RI. Which is more reactive towards this reaction? So, not only this reaction, everywhere RI is more reactive. Why? Reason also we have studied in previous class. See, you know, you take HF, HCl. Okay, here is HI. So, down the group, what happens? Size of the halogen, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine increases. As the size increases, what happens? This bond length is increases. When bond length increases, bond breaking energy decreases. It means HI can be broken so easily. Now, similarly, RF, RCl, RBr, RI. This RI bond length is very large. Due to large bond length, the breaking bond become easy. When the bond is broken easily, then it can be react with ammonia easily. Therefore, which is more reactive? Alkyl iodides are more reactive, bromide, chloride, fluoride. Even SN1, SN2 reaction also same order. Alkyl iodides are more reactive because the breaking of the bond become easy. Okay. So, next. Then, as we discussed that, in this method, you will get the mixture of amine. It is not suitable to prepare any one particular amine. But even though I want to prepare primary amine, what to do? Only I want primary amine. So, in order to prepare only primary amine, then there is one condition. take the alkyl halide and reacts with excess of ammonia. If you take excess of ammonia reacts with RX, you'll get the major product is primary amine. You'll get major, it is not that 100%. You'll get other product also, but you'll get major is primary amine. So therefore, to prepare primary amine as a major product, then we take excess of ammonia. Okay, so it is about Hoffman ammonolysis. Okay, right on. Right, alkyl halides reacts with ammonia. Alkyl halides reacts with ammonia at 100 degree Celsius. To form the mixture of primary, secondary, tertiary and quaternary ammonium salt. Okay. This reaction is called Hoffman ammonolysis. Okay, take the equation. Rx